Hello everyone, once again I welcome you in my YouTube channel. In this video we are going to study the practice set 12.2 remaining examples. So let's start with the fifth example. Fifth example, in a two digit number the digit at tens place is twice the digit at unit place. If the number obtained by interchanging the digits is added to the original number, the sum is 66 and find the number. So here solution. First we will consider the digit which is at the unit place, that is x. So here I will write the digit let unit place digit. Then tens place digit, it is twice of it. It is given that tens place digit, it is twice the digit at the unit place. So here tens place digit would be 2x. Now we will find out the, or we will obtain the original number. The concept of expanded form. Here suppose if the number is 23, so if you want to write this number by using the expanded form, 2 is at the tens place, so here we write the 2 multiplied by 10 plus 3 is at unit place, so this we will use it here. In our case, in this case the tens place digit is 2x. As per this 2x we have to multiply by 10. So we will get the tens place digit or tens place 20. So here it is 2x multiplied by 10 plus unit place digit. Unit place digit we have considered x. So here if we will solve it or if we will simplify it, so 2x multiplied by 10, it is 20x plus x. That means we will get the original number 21x. Again they have said that we have to interchange the digit. So after interchanging digits, a new number, we will obtain the new number. Which is that, so here 2x, we will take it at the unit place digit, and x we will take it at the tens place digit. So just we will replace it. So we will get x multiplied by 10 plus 2x. X multiplied by 10, it is 10x plus 2x. That means after interchanging we will get the number 12x. Or you can see here 21x, so here we will get 12x. We have interchanged the digit. So what is the condition? By condition, the condition says that the number which we have obtained after interchanging the digit, it is nothing but 12x. It is added to the original number, then sum is 66. That means 12x plus, it is number after interchanging, plus original number 21x is equal to 66. If we will add it, we will get the answer 33x is equal to 66. And 33 transfer it here, so x is equal to 66 upon 33. And if we divide it, x is equal to 2. We will get the answer 2. X is equal to 2. Therefore, original number, it is nothing but 21x. 21x is equal to 21 multiplied by 2. So we got the answer 42. So original number is 42. In this sixth example, there are some tickets of rupees 200 and some tickets of 100 rupees. And these tickets are of a drama in a theater. The number of tickets of rupees 200 was 20 more than the number of tickets of 100. Right? Means whatever we have the number of tickets of 100 and whatever we have the number of tickets of 200, the difference in between them, it is of 20.
The total amount by the theatre was sale of by sale of tickets was ₹37,000. This is the total amount after selling which we have received. Now we'll find out the number of ₹100 tickets which we have sold. So your solution. Here they have said the number of tickets of ₹200 was 20 more than the number of tickets of ₹100. So here we will consider number of tickets is x. Sorry, of ₹100 it is x. So what is number of tickets of ₹200? They are more by 20. So if it is x, so it is x plus 20. X plus 20. Now we have to find out the total amount which we have got it. Suppose the 100 rupees notes are x, therefore the amount of the 100 rupees would be 100x. So same thing, if we have the 200 notes are x plus 20, so the amount would be, therefore amount would be 200 multiplied by x plus 20. If we have the 1 note, so 100 multiplied by 1. If we have 2 notes, so 100 multiplied by 2. So here we have the x note, so 100 multiplied by x. It is the amount for these rupees. And for 200 rupees, we get the amount 200 multiplied by x plus 20. Now we'll go to the condition. The condition, they said that total amount is collected, it is 37,000. So by condition, total amount. So what is the first amount? First amount is 100x. Second amount is 200 into x plus 20. And what is the total amount is given? 37,000. Now we have to solve. 100x as it is plus. Multiply inside the bracket now. So we will get 200x plus, if you will multiply here, so you will get 4,000 is equal to 37,000. 100x plus 200, it is 300x plus 4,000 as it is equal to 37,000. Transfer 4,000 on that side, so we will get here 300x is equal to 37,000 minus 4,000. Now we will do the subtraction. So 300x as it is equal to, when we do the multiplication, sorry, subtraction of these two, will get the answer 33,000. X, keep it as it is. Here, if we will divide it, 33,000, now we have to divide it by 300. So here these zeros will be cancelled with each other, and if you will divide 330 by 3, you will get 110. Means x is 110. We have considered this x is nothing but number of tickets of ₹100. So here we got the solution. The tickets of ₹100 were sold are 110. Seventh example, of the three consecutive natural numbers, 5 times the smallest number is 9 more than the 4 times the greatest number. Find the numbers now. We have to solve it. So here we need the three consecutive natural numbers. So the numbers are, I will consider first number is x, second number I will get x plus 1, third number I will get x plus 2. So in this, x would be the smallest number and x plus 2 would be the greatest number. Now what is the solution? Here we have, what is the condition? By condition,
Now we will see the condition. What is the condition? Says that the smallest number, sorry, 5 times the smallest number. That means I have to take the smallest number 5 times. Now what is the smallest number in this? Here x. So I will consider 5x. Is 9 more. Means I have to plus 9. So in what I have to add 9? I have to add 9 in 4 times the greatest number. Greatest number is plus 2. And I have to take it 4 times. And in that I have to add 9. So this is my the condition. This is my condition. So I saw it 5x. Multiply inside the bracket. So here it will be 4x. 4 2's are 8. Plus 9. 5x is equal to 4x. 8 plus 9. It is 17. 4x transfer it here, 5x minus 2x is equal to 17. After subtraction, we get the answer 1x is equal to 17, that is x is equal to 17, which is our smallest number. If smallest number is x, 17, so the next number would be 18, 17 plus 1, 17 plus 2. So therefore, the numbers are 17, x plus 1 is equal to 17 plus 1 is equal to 18, x plus 2, that is 17 plus 2 is equal to 19. So we get the numbers 17, 18 and 19. 8th example, Raju sold a bicycle at 8% profit. Amit repaired it for spending Rupees 54. Then he sold a bicycle to Nikhil for rupees 1134 with no profit or no loss. So find the cost price of the bicycle for which Raju purchased. So here for Amit, no profit, no loss. It means that CV and SP for a week it was C, that means it is rupees 1134. But Amit, he has spent rupees 54 for the repairing the bicycle. So that was included in this CP. So here CP we have 1134. So from here, whatever he has spent for the repairing, that is in minus. Then that would be the selling price for the Raju. So here for the Raju, what is the selling price? SP would be the same thing, whatever the cost price is for the Amit. But Amit, he has paid extra 54 rupees. That we will separate it. So we will get the pure SP for the Raju. So for Raju, SP is equal to your CP of this, so 1134. From that, I'll minus it at repairing charges. So we will get the answer 1080 rupees. So this is the SP for the Raju. Now we will consider net CP for the Raju. It is X rupees. So what is the profit? So we will get the profit. What is the formula? SP minus CP, that is SP minus CP. So SP we have 1080, we have got it, minus X. Now we have the information that percent profit for the Raju, that is 8%. So percent profit is equal to profit upon CP multiplied by 2. We know this formula. So we'll put the values. Percent profit, it is nothing but 8%, that is 8. Profit just now we have found, it is 1080 minus x. 1080 minus x. CP is x multiplied by 100. Transfer this x on this side, so it will be 8x. So here we will get 1080 minus x. I'll put them in the bracket, multiply by 100. Multiply inside the bracket now. So we will get the answer
These two zeros will be added. So here 1,08,000 minus 100 multiplied by x, that is 100x. And here 8x. 100x transfer it here. 8x plus 100x is equal to 1,08,000. 100 plus this, so it is 108x is equal to 1,08,000. Transfer 108 on that side, so we will get the answer 1,08,000 divided by this is 108, and if we divide it, we will get the answer x is equal to 1,000, which is CP for Raju. So here they have told you to find out the cost price of the bicycle for Raju purchased it. It is rupees 1,000. Ninth question. A cricket player scored 180 runs in the first match and 257 runs in the second match. Find the number of runs in the third match so that average is will be 230. So here we will use the concept of a average. So what is the average? How to find out the average? Average is nothing but the sum of all observations is divided by the total number of observations. So here we will see the average. Before that we will consider late runs in third match which is x that we have to find out. So average, it is nothing but is equal to sum of runs and divided by total number of matches. So what is the sum of this? Average is given 230. Sum of runs. First match he has scored 180 runs. Second match he has scored 257 runs. Plus third match we have considered x runs. Divided by total number of matches would be 3. 3 transfer it here, so 230 multiplied by 3, and here we will get 180 plus 257 plus x. Multiply this, so we will get the answer 690, and here we can add this. So we will get 0 plus 7, 7, 8 plus 5, 13. And here 437 plus x. Now 437 transfer it here. 690 minus 437 is equal to x. And if you do the subtraction, you will get the answer 253 runs. So in third match, he scored 253 runs. Tenth and last example. Sudhi's present age is 5 more than the 3 times the age of Veeru's. Anil's age is half of the age of Sudhi, and the ratio is given of sum of Sudhi's and Veeru's age to 3 times the Anil's age is 5:6, and we have to find out the Veeru's age. So here we will consider late Veeru's age is x. If Veeru's age is x, then Sudhi's age. Here Sudhi's age is 5 more, means plus more, in 3 times the age of the Veeru. Veeru's age is x, so 3 times would be 3x plus 5. His age, here Anil's age is given, it is the half of the Sudhi's age. Whatever the Sudhi's age is there, it is a half of that, thus Anil's age. Here Sudhi's age is 3x plus 5, half of this, it is 3x plus 5 upon 2. So we have got the all three persons ages. So here my condition The condition is given
of the ratio. They have said this ratio of sum of Sudhis and Veeru's age. So sum of Sudhis is x. Sorry, Veeru's is x and Sudhis' age is 3x plus 5.
Sum of their ages, that is x plus 3x plus 5
to 3 times the Anil's age. Anil's age is this and it would be 3 times, that is 3 multiplied by 3x plus 5 upon 2. And this ratio, it is nothing but it is 5 upon 6. 5 is to 6. Now we will multiply. Before multiplication, I will add these two. So I will get 4x plus 5. And here I will get it 3 into 3x plus 5 upon 2 is nothing but 5 upon 6. We will multiply across 6 if we will transfer here. So this will be multiplication. So 4x plus 5. I will transfer 6 on this side. So multiply by 6 is equal to. Here 5 is there. And this denominator, if I shift on that side, so it will go in the multiplication. So I will get 3 into 3x plus 5 upon 2. This denominator I have shift on that side. Now multiply this inside the bracket. So here we will get 24x plus 30. 6 4s are and 6 5s are. Here 5 3s are 50. Then we will get your 3x plus 5 upon 2. Again 2 is in division or it's in denominator. If shift on this side, so it will go in the multiplication. We have to multiply this by 2. So we will get 24x plus 30 as it is. 2 shift on this side, so it will be in multiplication. Now 50 here 3x plus 5. Multiply again inside the bracket. So here we will get 2 multiplied by 24, 48x plus 2 multiplied by 30, it is nothing but 60, is equal to 53 is 45x and 15 5 is, so it will be 75. 45x transferred here. So 48x minus 45x plus 60 as it is equal to 75. 48 subtraction minus 48 minus 45, 3x plus 60 is equal to 75. 60 shift on that side, so 3x is equal to 75 minus 60. So 3x after subtraction, we will get the answer 50. Now 3 shift on that side, so x is equal to 50 upon 3. And which is nothing but x is equal to 5. Means here we have considered x, it's Veeru's age. Means Veeru's age is 5 years. So students, in this way we have solved the remaining examples from practice set 12.2. I hope you have understood all the examples. Thank you.